Hey everybody, welcome back to Omega Zone Gaming. So, I know I promised the God Eater review before, you know, Kingdom Hearts 2.8, and it will still come. I'll probably get it out tomorrow, but this weekend was the last chance for Nioh, last chance demo, and I figured, well, why not, let's play it together. I actually have not played it. I've booted up a few days ago before it was available to play and set my visual settings and crap, but aside from that, I personally, this is going to be new. I've heard this is sort of like Samurai Dark Souls. So we equip weapons from the status menu. Melee weapon 1. Wooden sword. Okay. We'll read this one. Quick attack. Square, strong attack, triangle. Okay, this seems a lot like Dark Souls right here. The quick attack doesn't consume much ki, but only causes light damage. The strong attack is powerful, but consumes more ki and lowers your guard. If your ki reaches 0, you will not be able to attack till it recovers. And they give you a little movie to show you combat. Okay. Okay, there we go. Lock on, R3, switch target, R left and right. Okay. When you lock onto an enemy, your camera stays focused on the target. Also displays the target's health and ki. Okay. Let's head across the bridge now. Yay! Okay, read. One plus X equals dodge. Okay, that didn't do a video, but quick suggestion, only use the arrows when you absolutely have to for dodging. It doesn't work really well, especially when you're being attacked. Switching stance. Okay, a high stance is R1 triangle, a mid stance is R1 and square, and a low stance is R1 and X. High stance emphasizes attack power. It allows for powerful techniques. Mid stance is good for defense. It has a wide range of techniques and is easy to use. Low stance is good for dodging. It doesn't consume much ki and also maintains your guard as you move. Oh, okay, so you don't have to hold it, you just have to quick switch. Okay, that makes better sense. Okay. I just found out X is you're running. Key pulse R1 while blue lights gather around you after an attack. Gotta deal full line to get that one. Yokai realm, another world born from the yokai. When you are in the yokai realm, your ki recovery speed is greatly reduced. Conservatively, the powers of the yokai themselves are enhanced here. Purify recovers the maximum amount of ki from a successful ki pulse in the yokai realm. It also cleanses the defilement of the yokai realm from your person, restoring you to normal. Yay, we completed all the mission tutorials. Go forward. Yes. Okay, so at your starting point, you get a shrine, a blacksmith, a dojo, a touring gate, which plays in different online modes. I'm guessing that's something similar to Dark Souls Invasion mode. A hidden tea house, which can't be used in the demo version, and storehouse to store your items. Blacksmith will sell you items, forge or dismantle your equipment. Okay, so we're going to go to the Tokai region. Strange lilies have bloomed out of season, releasing miasma and futama that has caused crops to wither and people to starve. However, I don't believe this to be the work of yokai. Atsatsu knows the area well. If it had been yokai, she would have already informed us. Though it pains me to say it, with Lord Yesu's life at stake, I cannot afford any diversions. If I must go, William, go without me. I will be heading towards Hamatsu. Okay, let's try area. Town of Futama and Toan's Providence is where the Tinyu River and the Futama River merge. This, in addition to the proximity to the highway, makes it an invaluable location for the Towaga army. Although the powerful Takeda family once claimed the area, Yaizu succeeded in taking it back. Futama is also well known as the site of death of Yaizu's eldest son, Noibayusa. And if I mispronounced any of that in your Japanese, I apologize. I'm not fluent in the language. Or the pronunciations. Okay. What are you? I'm guessing a save point? Some sort. Oh, okay, so this is where you make offerings to receive armada. Functions that are locked. Let's see. Offer an Odichi cup to summon a visitor. Change guardian spirit and level up. Well, let's try the level up function. Can't level at all because I need 250 to do so, but let's go ahead and continue on then. Hey, okay then. I guess we're going back. Already hit that 250 mark. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and level up. We'll level up body, which is your health, right? Let's see what each does. So, body affects life and resistance to poison paralysis. Weapons mainly affect affected spears. Affects key weapons mainly effective swords and bows. Stamina affects life and how much you can carry. Strength. Amount required to activate the special effects of heavier weapons and armor. So, that affects cannon, that affects axes, skills. The amount required to activate the special effects of more technical weapons and armor. Dual swords, guns. It looks like its main effect is. Dexterity determines the affecting capacity of your ninjutsu. Magic determines the effect and capacity of Amio magic. I hope I didn't butcher that, but I think I did. Spirit affects the power of your guardian spirit. Let's go with stamina for now. Skill point attained. Merchant Memories, which looks like a journal, basically. You got your system setting status, skills customization, learn skills. Okay, so here we go. I think I have a spear on my back, don't I? I also have a sword, though. So, let's go ahead and learn a sword skill. Okay. There we go. Let's continue on down the road. Draw from him. Whoa. There we go. Okay, so that was my quick fill on that. Items, let's see, sacred water. Okay, so is that a shortcut? No, you know, I'll use that from here. So So we're gonna see about shooting somebody. Let's see if we can do that. There we go. Switch this to work. Whoa. Oh, if it'll let me. Shit, 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 shit. Die. I mean, I like the game. I see me dying a lot, though. I really do. Oh, okay, that was dope. Okay, that was kick-ass. He got me. He got me. Okay, so I make my way back down. Whoa! Okay, was not expecting that. So, a rev vent. I gotta remember those. Free from this motor. I do like that. I do like how they keep the whole, like, Japanese samurai motif. Okay. Keep with the middle stance. Yeah, I should go with the low stance. I don't like that one attack. Okay, so that's a rifle. damn it. Nope.
Right through your head, motherfucker. Okay. I found some armor. Okay. Equipment. Die. No. There we go. Okay, this issue's intense. Dual katanas. Whoa! That guy, like, really came after me there. let's see. Oh, that's a cool aspect. You have familiarities with weapons. It's actually really cool. motherfucker. Back off. And I died again. I do have to say, overall, I like it. It's a really cool game. Overall, really good concept. Take the Dark Souls formula and put it in a samurai style, bro. You guys thought this one good for pretty through pretty good, I gotta admit. Okay, I'm gonna try a couple spear attacks. We'll see what those do. Okay, so spears can do less damage but a wider shot, it looks like. I hit X. I don't know why I didn't roll. I hope you're all entertained. Hope me dying is well worth it. You die. There we go. Lock that away, game. Son of a... I think what I'm liking about the martial arts motif is it's kind of harder for me to grasp the movements of, because they're faster paced than what you normally see in, like, the Souls games. My opinion, this is like the perfect mashup between like Dark Souls and Bloodborne. Spear dude has some speed. Okay. Let's go to the equipment real quick. I'm gonna try out these dual swords real quick. Oh, yes. Okay, dual swords are excellent. Damn, if it wasn't for that boulder, I would have had him. But, yeah, guys. Dual swords are definitely going to be your best friend in this game. I recommend equipping those as soon as you can. They're fast striking and they do a lot of damage. Bastard. Yeah, as soon as you get dual swords equipped, I wish I would have had them equipped when I first went in. So I probably would have lived a lot longer and gotten further in. Problem is now I can't get to my little spirit dude, which has all my orbs. Take that, yes, OB. Okay, so they have trap boxes. Oh, I love this game. Okay, everybody, so let's discuss this a little bit. That was fun. Even though I'm going to be watching Dot being killed over and over again, that was fun. So, the gameplay is familiar, but different. I do like that. I do like that it feels like a Dark Souls or Bloodborne. But it also has its differences. I also like how fast paced, you would say it is. It seems like it's faster in Bloodborne, but not quite as fast as Dark Souls 3 ended up doing with its balance. I also like the graphics. I love this Chinese samurai warrior type thing that they're doing with it. I think that's really cool. I like how there's different martial artist stances for the swords. I think that's cool. I like how there's some different firearms and stuff. The hand cannon I like. The dual swords I like. The only one complaint I may have, and I don't really see this as a complaint, it's more of a suggestion. For a full release, either spread out the enemies a little bit more, or nerf them a small bit, not too much, but a small bit, because I could see a lot of even Souls veterans getting irritated with this. I completed Bloodborne myself, and while I was having fun, I was like, yeah, advance, I can't advance. So, I do appreciate the difficulty, but I can see where others may not. But I do like where this is going. I hope this turns into just as big of a franchise as Dark Souls and Bloodborne did. This is really an interesting concept. I think I might have one more demo video in me tonight. We'll find out here in a second. If I can get on and get a little bit of it in before I'm too tired out after uploading this video, we'll do that one. I'll leave that as a surprise. Until next time, this is Omega Zone Gaming, and I am out.